Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you the exclusive to PMT Antiquity AQ35. Pelham Blue, Cherry, and Vintage Sunburst. All as beautiful as the last. Antiquity guitars are a great way to get the look, sound, feel, and vibe of the guitars our idols play for not a lot of money. Seriously, these guitars are crazily priced, all linked in the description box down below so you can check them out at pmtonline.co.uk. We've obviously got the ES style guitars, plenty other variants around me right now, all shapes and sizes, in some cases left-handed variants available for no extra cost. They're just fantastic. But in this video, we'll be focusing on the AQ35 and all of its hollow body glory. This Pelham Blue one is just, well, as you heard in the intro, proper Dave Grohl vibes, isn't it? You guys don't know how lucky you are. When I first started playing guitar many moons ago, affordable guitars sucked. They just straight up sucked. They were made out of very peculiar woods. They kind of looked a bit off, and the setup and the action was always just straight up ridiculous. But these days, with Antiquity, the wood choices are that of the originals. The setup and playability is just fantastic straight out of the box. And again, you're not going to bust the bank to get the guitar of your dreams. It's just fantastic. There's a few different ways in which you might enjoy an Antiquity. Obviously, if you are a beginner, just starting out, or the way I personally use them. Like, I'm not much of a Tele guy. I rarely play Telecasters, but every now and then I want to scratch that Telecaster itch. If I want that, again, look, feel, vibe, and tone, but I don't want to spend a lot of money on a Telecaster, Antiquity is a great way for me to just get that Telecaster tone and feel for not a lot of money. And for the modders out there, the folk that like to mod a guitar, if you want a great solid bass to modify on top of and make a guitar your own, again, Antiquity is a great bass to start from because the quality and components of these guys are just second to none. Let's get into the specs of this. Sorry, like this, for example. Rosewood Tele for cheap as chips. Everyone knows what kind of guitar this is based off, and it's, yeah, not a lot of money at all. So, the AQ35, maple construction, that classic ES style with the violin F-holes up top, based off the world's first mass-produced, readily available hollow body guitar. We all know the kind of vibe, but it's a lot more expensive than this. So maple construction, you've got a center block down the middle to help with any feedback or unwanted noise. Two wonderful vintage voiced humbuckers that deliver that wonderful old school bold thick sound you desire from a guitar like this. A volume for each pickup, a tone for each pickup, and a three-way selector just down there. There's binding on the entire guitar, again, very aesthetically pleasing. But what's cool about the cost of these guitars and the way they're constructed is set necks. So the neck isn't bolted on, it's actually glued into the body. And that's quite an expensive manufacturing process because it's glued in as opposed to just bolt on. And when it's made like this, besides the fact that it's hollow, it just resonates like an absolute champ, whether it's plugged in, acoustic, whether you just sat on the sofa while your missus or your fella is watching Corey. Perfect guitar for that. Rosewood fingerboard, 22 frets again, there's binding up the neck, that wonderful Antiquity headstock with the vintage style tune-up tuners up top. That's all the specs. I'm gonna go into a Boss Katana, which is mic'd up with an SM57 by Shure just off camera there. Let's get some dirty sounds first, and then some clean sounds. I'll switch over to the vintage Sunburst, because I think it just looks absolutely impeccable, doesn't it? Fantastic thing. One little spec I've got to mention, all the hardware is nickel, so the tunematic bridge and tailpiece, all nickel. Again, a nice little kind of vintage inspired spec as opposed to like the bright brash chrome. Anyways. Thank you. sound great for lead work, but chords just ring out because it's a big old semi-hollow. Right, let's hear with some clean tones there. Like the middle pickup on ES style guitars, because they are, it's not like an acoustic, but it is somewhat like an acoustic. Like the neck pickup is that kind of woolly back inside, the bridge pickup is that spruce top in the middle. It's almost like an acoustic vibe. Out the factory, they are set up great, so obviously they sound great with clean stuff. The tone down, you can get some very jazzy kind of... Well, the jazz is out there. Play, mash your hands against a fingerboard and play a jazz. But yeah, they really shine with a bit of distortion. That whole Joe Bonamassa, Dave Grohl thing. Let's go back to some gain. And that, ladies and gentlemen, I believe is all the side specs and sounds I can give you from the amazing Antiquity AQ35. Let us know what you think down below in the comments, because I think it's special. I've actually got one of these Sunburst ones in order. I would have had a Sino, but everyone keeps bloody buying them, so this one will be mine very soon. But I care what you say, so comment down below and let us know what you think. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. Any more information, all the guitars, link in the description box down below. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.